The knowledge, you have to understand. The knowledge is easy, but it's for you to extend the knowledge. Is Benjamin online? Rick, can you see Benjamin behind?
I'm here.
Yes.
Good morning, Benjamin.
Hello, good morning, sir. How are you?
Not too bad. Are you ready to share with us the understanding of the holding of the plasma within the matter?
Yeah, I'm ready to share with you. Daniel is around here. He even wanted to go away, but I told him, no, you asked me to start right away, and
please,
lo and behold.
Please, so, to share the knowledge, you're achieving a beautiful dimensions in plasma technology. Let us understand.
Okay, so today we are going to share with you is a soap that we made, and Daniel, after doing it, Daniel was able to do the microbiology analysis in his lab, and then the results was amazing. The estimated bacteria killing time was within the 15 minutes range. So after 15 minutes, when you open the cultured containers, all the bacteria were gone. So he was really amazed, and he told us that, you know, this is a good product, it will sell on the market, and he wanted us to even do a further work on it. For now, we are going to share with you the hard soap, the hard one. We also have a liquid one which is sitting on his table currently.
Can you share your screen with us? We don't
screen.
See anything.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to share
that we can see what you're talking about, please.
Okay. I'm going to share my screen with you. Share. And then, is it coming?
Yes, we see the bottles.
Okay, so that is what we are going to share today. That's Keshe Foundation Ghana Nano Soap Microbiology Report, and we are currently at the Ghana Space Science Center. I'm here with Daniel from the microbiology lab, and he has been doing a lot of analysis with us. So I want to go straight into the PowerPoints that we have. Everybody who is watching or, you know, is listening to us, probably in his lifetime have used a soap before. And so basically a soap is a substance used together with water for washing and cleaning. And it is made up from two compounds, normally natural oils or animal fats with sodium hydroxide or another strong alkali. The fats, some people call it tallow, and normally after doing this composition, they add perfume and color to it, and then they achieve, you know, the soap. So, did you know that soap have been used for human beings at least for the last 6,000 years in one form or the other? So, I mean, it's something we cannot live without. And soap was first made by the Babylonians. And historical references point to the fact that soap making were used in the textile industry, and it is still used in the textile, and we use it to wash ourselves and then wash our clothes. And then we use it for medicine. Over here in Ghana, there are some local medicine which is soap driven. You know, they put small in the water and people use it as, put it in a string as an enema. And then they, you know, so that they can wash their intestines. So that is something that I know for sure that people do here. But how safe, and, you know, our ancestors have been doing it, so I believe it's medicinally, you know, powerful. That's so. So this also there's a historical fact about soap. It was the ancient Europeans who started using soap, and in France, they had a lot of factories which spread finally to Italy, and then the British also, seeing the boom in this business, jump on the train, and then the first factory was situated in Bristol in the 12th century. After that, they established another one in Cheapside in London in the 13th century, and because they got a lot of money from that, because everybody was using it, so they thought it could, you know, serve as, you know, taxing, you know, for the government. So during the Napoleonic era, government inspectors even went to homes. People were doing it illegally, so they were able to get into homes and then seize pans of soap makers so that they will not be able to produce these products in the night. Okay, so that was what, you know, happened. Historical facts, some historical facts about soap. Now let's look at the modern facts. What's our trend of soap usage? It's estimated that about 10 billion pounds per year or so, you know, is used by the is used overall, and US uses 1/3 of it. The per capita consumption is 25 pounds per, and then Netherlands, followed by Netherlands, and 20 pounds by UK, Japan 7, Brazil, and so on and so forth. Okay, so the uses are classified. We have 92 and laundry. US use about 85% for laundry and 12% for toilet, so and so on. So that, this is a source from the soap magazine that I quoted from. Okay. In doing this thing, I form a team, and some of them are on the way coming. Esther, Lebanon, myself, and Nash, and then Esther again, and then Nafisa to Adam. These are from the chemistry lab, so we decided to, you know, do this together here. So that's the team, as you see over there. And these are the ingredients we use. We use sodium hydroxide, soda ash, coconut oil, pumpkin, glycerin, shea butter, cocoa butter, fragrance, and nanomaterial, and water. So these are, you know, the stuff that we use. And I will go into details why I even chose these materials to use in the making of the soap in the first place, because it have a lot of medicinal benefits. So first of all, to get further, I want you to understand that the skin of man is the largest organ of the human body. It is easy to be poisoned through the surface of the skin easily, because when you get, that is why when you get into a mono in an environment where there's monocarbon, you can easily, because you, it can seep into your bloodstream faster, and then you be able to lose your life faster also. So the skin does not only protect the internal organs and systems of man, it also gives visible and emotional feedback. So when you have rashes in some part of your body, it's telling you, it's like the instrumentation panel of a car. When the red signal shows or the indicator move to E, you know that your car fuel is getting, you know, empty, so you have to feel it. The same thing applies to the body. When you, it gives you visible signs of what is happening inside. And those who have been doing the GANS partners, we have learned that this putting, creating a three layer of, you know, a paper or a cotton layer, you are able to mimic these layers of the skin, epidermis, dermis, and then the hypodermis. This is a three layer of the skin. So if somebody have pain, if you know, understand these things carefully, you can easily look at this structure and then bring back or restore the health to the body, because it is basically operating based on the plasma principle of gravitational and magnetic field, the whole body, you know, of man. So as you see, also there are hair follicles, and so if hey, if water sits, a little bit of water sits on the body, you know, it can seep into the bloodstream easily, because it, there is an enabling path created by nature for any liquid to seep into the bloodstream very quickly. So, I mean, bathing even with good water or a soap which is well treated can enhance your total well-being. So that's the skin of man for you. Okay. So like I said before, we chose the materials for this production of soap very carefully because we believe that coconut oil have a lot of properties, okay, because looking at the coconut itself, it's a plasma on it, on the way the water is inside the coconut, and you know the whole structure, it's like the nature of the earth itself, okay. So coconut oil consists of healthy fat called medium chain fatty acids, MCFAs. These unique fats include caprylic acid, lauric acid, and capric acid. Okay, let me show you a little bit or give you a pictorial evidence of the medium chain fats. Okay, for instance, when you take the normal frying, you take the normal oil and then you put it on fire, and then you put a coconut oil and then you put it on another fire and set this set the fire at the same time, you see that the coconut oil, you know, burns faster than the ordinary oil, okay. So it is easier for the body to digest, and it is also the body is able to consume coconut oil, and it is not stored at fast. And coconut oil has antimicrobial and antifungal properties. Because of this property, the cell is able to use it and release its energy quickly. So coconut oil is easily processed by the liver because when it's fatty and it cannot melt, it is difficult for the liver to, you know, process, and it end up, you know, accumulating all kinds of filth in the liver, and it created a lot of help. It is one body part that works all the time, so it needs to be freed all the time. So coconut oil is best for your body. Like I have learned, if you want to put water in your car, if you can consume the water yourself, then you can also give it to the car. But if the water is not good for you to consume, then when you also put it in the car, it will damage. The same thing applies to if you can apply it to your body and it will suit your body well, then when it enters into your mouth also, your body can process it well. So the second ingredient we use also was cocoa butter. Cocoa butter has also anti-aging properties. That means the ladies, we are currently working on released what we are doing now. We are working on ointment also with the GANSes, okay, so that you can use it to treat asthma and stuff like that, any skin disease. Cocoa butter can help improve the quality of hair. It is good also in maintaining the overall skin health. Cocoa butter can be used to reduce inflammation. It has a high quantity of antioxidant, and so it is able to fight free radicals, okay. Cocoa butter also has high fatty acid, and it is able to, because of this high fatty acid, it is able to enter into the skin very well, and then if it is infused with proper medicine, it can, you know, heal, you know, the body very well also. So the next one is, this one is plenty here in Africa, in the tropical zones, and this is palm tree. And out of the palm tree, we get a palm kernel oil. And if you were watching CNN or you were following what happened during the Katrina, it was one of the trees that was able to stand the storm. You know, most of the trees were falling, fell off, was hit by the hurricane. But the palm tree stood, and over here, nothing from the palm tree is thrown off. Everything is useful, right from the root to the fruit. Nothing is, you know, for me, I've used the oil. We use the whole thing for food. We use it for, you know, fuel, and so many things. Okay, so we also have seen that it's loaded with zero cholesterol. That means it's good for people with Alzheimer's, you know, and people with diseases like, you know, who want to reduce their cholesterol. And in that line, we can also deal with diabetes in this regard. It is loaded with antioxidant also. It is unsaturated fat, rich in vitamin K, and zero trans fat. You know, it does not store the fat. What does mean? It does not store the fat. It doesn't keep it. It releases its energy, and it contains a lot of vitamin A, and it has a long shelf life. Okay, and then it's filled with other nutrients, and it can improve your hair growth, and it provides also soft skin, softness for your skin naturally. So these are inculcated, or it is by and parcel, part and parcel of the palm kernel. Okay, so we start with the soap making process, and that is step one. As you see, Nash with us. Nash is diluting the caustic for us, the caustic for us to dissolve in water, and that is some of the ingredients that we use, the caustic. So we have this mixture being done by him, and you can see the ash bottle over there. That's what it has, and we poured a little bit of the caustic in the cup so that he can mix it. And then after that, we went and then measured all the oil and then have it melted, and then we pour them into a mixing bowl, as you can see, and then added the soda ash slowly and then stir them, and then we added the
Benjamin.
Yes,
we go back. Go back two steps and explain the last two steps again, please. Go back to frame after the coconut and the palm. Go back.
This one?
Yes. Explain from this step by step, please.
Okay. So coconut oil has anti-aging properties. That means when you put it on, maybe your face is beginning to have lines, okay, in front of your face. As I said, when somebody's face starts folding, we can use the coconut oil, and like I showed in the picture of the skin, the coconut oil, the cocoa butter, because of these qualities, it can penetrate into the foreskin of the skin, the skin, and then enter into the dermis, and you know, increase the, what do you call it, the overall health of the skin. So it can also add to the good quality on your, what do you call it, the skin of your hair or the scalp of your head. So when you smear it, the ladies, they know it, cocoa butter. I recently had a lot of students from different countries of Africa, the IEA students, and most of them, when I show them the property of the cocoa butter, most of them bought, you know, huge, you know, quantities from here, and then took it to their locations, wherever they were coming in from. So that is another quality, because one of the guys from Rwanda told me it is very expensive in Rwanda to get the cocoa butter, but it's so cheap here, you know, to get. So they bought a lot of them and then carried them along. So it's good for maintaining skin health. Cocoa butter can be used to reduce inflammation. That means if somebody has pain and you mix it with the right, you know, stuff, you can also reduce inflammation of the skin. And antioxidant. Cocoa butter is high in antioxidant, which help fight off free radicals. So free radicals in the blood system. If you use it, we can use it to cook as well. So using it to cook will also end up fighting these free radicals in your body. Cocoa butter has also high fatty acid. That means it have this MCFE, medium chain fatty acid, okay? And it can penetrate into the layer of the skin very well and then help heal the skin. Okay. Mr. Keshe, should I go over this again?
No, go back, go down. So you just explain, go to the next page, how you make the soap.
Okay, so making the soap was simple. That, as you see in the picture, that is Nash, measuring the caustic and dissolving it in the conical flax, as you see over there. And then after this, we measured all the oils and then have them melted, and then we pour them into a mixing bowl, as you can see it here, and then added the NOH, that's the sodium hydroxide, and continued stirring until a thick mixture is obtained, and then we added a fragrance. Okay, we added a fragrance. Okay. After this step, we then continue stirring on we added GANS and stirred it until it was evenly mixed up in this the soap mixture. That's as you can see over here.
What kind of GANS did you add?
So we, as you can see over here, we have CO2, we have CH3, and then we have copper oxide. So we did a lot of configuration that I will show it in the next slide. So that is it. This part is the palm kernel oil, the one with the red fruit. That's the palm kernel oil. And then the white ones over here are the coconut oil. As you can see, if you look at the picture, you see at the lid edge of the plastic containers, you have copper oxide GANS, okay, and then you have CO2 plus CH3, you know, and then we have control and then control also. But this is just a little bit of what we have, because we did a different configuration because of what you are looking out for, which I will explain in the jiffy. We have copper oxide plus CO2, and then we have different configurations, CH3 and copper oxide, CH3 and CO2 mixed together, and then some went, you know, on their separate, you know, containers. Okay, so if you have understood the plasma, the science behind this plasma, and if you are interpreting it physically, you see that the CO2 controls the blood system or the motions. Okay. And then the CH3 controls your neural system, that is the energy flow. And then the copper oxide controls the lymph system, which has to do with your physical well-being or your physicality or your the physical structure. So if somebody, as I have seen, and I've seen it always and always here, when somebody have deep pain, like people, somebody have a pain on their hand or a swell or a sore on their hand, and then you apply the GANS, normally they are in pain immediately, but afterwards when you apply the three layers on the skin, these people suddenly go to sleep quickly. They go to sleep quickly and immediately. If Nash was around, he would, you know, confirm that when he had burns on the hand and the doctors were, you know, drilling him here, go and come tomorrow. And I said, why don't you let me try this on your skin? And he allowed me to treat him. He, the following day, I think the next day after treatment, he came to me and said, Benjamin, even if I sleep, even if it's 1 hour, it is, you know, good. I feel so good about it. And after 1 week, the whole thing was gone, and fire burns, which normally leave a scar, you know, left no trace of scar on the skin. If you were, he was, you know, around, he would have, you know, shown it to you. Like you can see, there's no, he will show you the area where he experienced the burn. There's no physical trace of the burn, and the skin looked beautiful, you know. So that is the representation. So we were looking for energy flow where we wanted to deal. If we are looking for something that will help improve your emotions, make you happy. Then we use the CH3 and then the CO2 GANS. And then when we're dealing with pain and stuff like that, we mix the copper oxide GANS and then the CO2 GANS. And then when we wanted to increase the field of, the emotions also, we use the CH3, GANS, because when you are talking about CH3, you are talking of field amplification, which has to do with the CH3 GANS. Okay, so that is the various nano GANS compositions. So after this, you can see that this, we left the soap, allowing the soap to cure. What is mean by curing is we allow the soap to sit so that the water used in preparing the soap, evaporates, because you use water, distilled water, in dissolving the sodium hydroxide. So curing means simply you allow the soap to sit for weeks, 4 to 6 weeks. During this time, the water used in the recipe evaporates. And the advantage here is that the cure soap has a firmer texture and it lasts for longer in shower. Okay, so as you can see here, this one have CO2 GANS and then CO control. We selected this one so we can show it to you. The coconut oil is still, has the liquid texture after even the weeks of sitting. Okay. But this, the white one, the one which appears white on the surface, is hard and very hard because it had a GANS in it. And this is the palm kernel oil. They almost look the same, but when you feel it, you can see the difference also. The one with the copper oxide is also harder, okay? So that is what you can see on the PowerPoint. At this juncture, after the 6 weeks time, we decided to package the soap and then send it to the microbiology lab for analysis. So we had a lot of Ziploc bags and then labeled them with various code, which I'm revealing it to Daniel now because he didn't know what was inside. We wanted to do a blind study so that he doesn't, influence the results anyway. So we labeled it. What you see here is HS. HS means hard soap, and then the L is lab. So HSL lab. That is hard soap that was made in the lab. And as you can see, there are also some bottles here. And I don't have, because we'll be doing the next time, I will show you how the bottles are looking. They are collapsing on themselves because the GANS energy, the energy released by the GANS is so much that it is shocking everything. You can see the bottles, and he's here to testify of it. So as you can see, HSL5, okay, HLS3, and so on. And we gave him a large spectrum of, samples that he said it was so plenty and it couldn't match the number of petri dishes that they had in the lab. So we have to go out and then look for some more, for him to be able to analyze the stuff for us. And as you can see, these are the petri dishes that incubation period, and I'm going to hand it over to him because this is his part. He's going to deal with the microbiology aspect of it, and then we'll see how effective the GANS behaved on the pathogens. And talking about pathogens, he will go into details about the pathogens we are dealing with here. We are dealing with Staphylococcus aureus, and then we are dealing with E. coli, and then we are Salmonella typhi, which can affect human beings. So that is what Daniel will be sharing with us in the next couple of slides so that you can, you know, have it. Nash is also around now. Nash is around. I'm handing over to...
Okay, so good morning. I'm Daniel Labi, Microbiology Lab.
Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us.
Yes, thank you too. Okay, so this is how the work started. We prepared a 24-hour culture of Escherichia coli, Salmonella typhimurium, and Staphylococcus aureus, which are all pathogenic organisms that we isolated from beef. Okay, so these are the organisms we use for the work. And this is how the Staphylococcus looks like on a plate. And this is actually what we isolated in the lab. It's not a picture. Yeah, so Staphylococcus aureus is a type of bacteria, and it stains positive, and it's non-motile, small round shape or non-motile cocci. In that microscopically they are clustered, they are not in chains. There are two types. We have Streptococcus, which is in chains. Then the Staphylococcus, that is how to differentiate them. Staphylococcus is always in a cluster form. Okay, then this is also how the E. coli looks like. It is the most prevalent infection organism in the family of gram-negative bacteria known as the Enterobacteriaceae. Enterobacteriaceae are microorganisms that are found in the intestines of animals, both human beings and animals. Then this is also Salmonella typhi, a very infectious organism. Okay, so this is how the work was done. We prepared three concentrations from each soap sample that was brought to the lab. 10%, 30, and then 50% were prepared by dissolving. We dissolved them in 100 ml of distilled water in a 250 ml container, and we left them overnight to dissolve completely. Okay. Okay, so after preparation, leaving them overnight to dissolve, we added 1 ml of the test organisms that we used for the tests. And the test organism, we prepared an inoculum. The inoculum was prepared with a McFarland standard, which is usually of a 1.2 times 10 to the power 8. That is a lot of microorganisms. And we prepared them in a McCartney bottles and prepared a serial dilution out of it, two-fold dilution, because from the assurance Benjamin gave me that the soaps are very effective. So we prepared only two-fold dilutions. And to my surprise, after a killing time of 15 minutes, all the organisms were eliminated as shown in the plates. You know, we have 50%, 10%, and then 30%. These are the plates that represent for Escherichia coli. All of them were eliminated. Okay. Okay, so so pure colonies of Salmonella appear red. That is when, if they are like I have shown, this is Salmonella. This is how it looks like. So pure colonies of Salmonella appear red without or with or without a distinct black spot at the center of XLD. XLD is the media that Salmonella grows on. Cellulose, oxygen, deoxychocolate, agar. Typical colonies of Staphylococcus aureus also appear black with a clear zone around on the media, bed packer agar, that's BP agar. Okay, so this is the results for all the soaps were three. So we prepared three concentrations from each, 50%, 30%, and then 10%. But for HSL1, HSL1, the quantity was not up to expectation, so we couldn't prepare 50%. What we had, I think, 33% point 86. Okay, so the colony forming unit that you see, those are the counts, what the expected count from each plate. Nothing was detected there. That's why you see 0000. Okay.
Excuse me, can you go back? So what does this mean? The application after 15 minutes shows no E. coli, no salmonella, no...
No salmonella, no stuff.
Doesn't matter which soap you used, which concentration.
Yeah, which concentration, everything went off. So with the liquid ones in the lab now, we are going to reduce the concentration to 5, 10, and 15 to see if it can still be effective. So it's to either we reduce the concentration or reduce the concentration of the GANS that is added to the soaps to see the minimum inhibitory effect. So for this one, the minimum inhibitory effect was 10%.
And your total residual at the end is zero. You couldn't find any?
Yeah, zero, yes. There was nothing there.
Okay. Go ahead, please. Can you tell us what's your conclusion?
From the results, it can be, it's very obvious. The soap is very effective. It's very effective. So as I said, with the next one, we are going to reduce the GANS to see how effective it will still be. I understand this one, they added 1 mL of the GANS. So we are reducing it to 0.5 in the next analysis and see how it will go.
That's beautiful. Thank you very much. What's your conclusion? We saw the conclusion, it went back up.
Okay.
So the conclusion is that because of this performance, because of this, it has proven to be effective, and currently we are doing another, what do you call it, test on the soap. We have samples on the test in the lab, the liquid soap, which is undergoing a similar analysis in the microbiology lab at this place. And so, like you said, we are reducing the sample, the quantity of the GANS use, and we want to try the effectiveness. We want to carry another sample whereby people will wash their hands with the soap, and then we'll analyze it. We'll analyze this the effectiveness. And I was talking with the microbiologist from the Water Research Institute, and he said the very best place to do this are the public toilets, you know. And so we're going to take samples of water and the soap to that place, and then they wash, and then we'll collect the samples, and then we'll analyze the water and see before and after. We'll allow some people to wash their hands in the clean water before washing it in the nano environment, the nano soup environment, and then we will test the effectiveness of this. So that's the next test that we want to, as part of the, to test the efficacy of this and the performance of the nano soup. You know, we want to do that. And then the next projects, you know, is for treatment of various skin ailments. That's what we want to do. GANS bead coconut oil ointment and GANS bead sperm kernel oil and ointment. That's our next project, and which I'll be doing with Esther. You know, she just came in. Esther is here. She just came in. So that's what we'll be doing. And so that is it, Mr. Keshe. If you have any question.
Yes. I have a very big question, and what I would like you to do, what I would like you to go, is to go all the way back to very first 2, 3, 4 frames of this presentation, please, where you speak how you produce soap.
Okay. So this place.
Okay. Now, go to the next picture, please. Okay. In your talks, you're in a perfect frame. In the teaching, you showed us historically people add caustic to the fat, caustic to oil. So, if you stand still with the present knowledge we have, man already has been in the GANS making system and nano making system for centuries. You add caustic to amino acid, to fat, to human fat. And now you understand. You go and get the water from the sea and you add NOH to it to make what you call the sea GANS. Man has been making protein GANS for centuries. Soap is a type of natural GANS with amino acid. If you understood this, now you understand we have all been GANS makers the way we've been nanomaterial makers for centuries without knowing. The reason, do you understand? Benjamin?
Yes, sir.
Do you understand what it means?
Yeah. I will add a contribution to it. If you people have watched the movie Fight Club, when Brad Pitt was narrating to his apprentice or the guy he wanted to recruit, he went to where the beautician clinic and then collected the fat of human beings. What the fat people, when they get to this clinic, their fat is sucked, and then that is what this guy used in preparing the soap. And he sells the soap to the same people who gets to the, what do you call it, the beauty clinic to go and take the fat. And they didn't know the content of the soap. And so this guy was asking him, his apprentice was asking him, why do we use this thing? He said, to make the best soap, you need tallow. That's the fat of human beings or animals. And then he went on further to say, the Asian people discovered that in some part of rivers, they were able to wash their things properly. Why? Because on the hills where the rivers flow, that is where the human sacrifices were made in those days. So the ashes, when it rains, the ashes are carried along and it mixes it with the wood ash. And the wood ash end up forming soap. And so that is how, you know, those portion of the rivers, you know, form, and they didn't understand the principles, but they ended up, you know, getting a soap or getting something to wash their clothes. So I mean, this knowledge have been with us, like you just said, since time immemorial, but we human beings have refused to learn. And sometimes when you tell people about the technology, it looks so simple that they begin to doubt, you know, what the efficacy or effectiveness.
They doubt their own intelligence. why I asked you to come to this frame is that to show, and we expand on it as you are, that in fact soap is a GANS state of protein, the fat. So now it should have been no surprise why when you add another GANS to a presently a state of GANS, you increase
the
potency to higher than the protein which was made by itself. That's why when you added CO2, when you added CuO, or when you added CH3, all work on Salmonella and all the other bacteria, because the foundation of the soap you made is already amino acid based. So all you need, all you've done, you added additional energy. In a way, you created a new virus. because the amino acid GANS is still there, which made the soap. Now you have made a virus which is stronger than Salmonella and everything else. And now, for the first time, you understand why your soaps work, kills bacteria. Because you have made a new virus, which is the energy of the CO2 added to the present GANS amino acid, which you created. And this is why it's so effective. In this new energy package which you have created, adding a GANS energy to another GANS energy, is more than what is held in the body of the man as viruses. And that's why you see destruction. You can go to the minimum amount of GANS. Don't use GANS in your next test. Just use the water of the GANS.
You will get GANS. Yeah, that's...
You understand? Because now
yes, sir.
you have added to the energy of the GANS of the amino acid, which you call soap. So this, for a lot of you, it becomes a new knowledge. Why the GANS works on bacteria. This, what you show us today, I wish we could go directly to South Ceylonian University, to the professors in the biology lab, in micro lab, which they did the same test 2 years ago. And they came up with the same result. But the World Health Organization blocked them to come out with the technology which was given by Keshe Foundation to them to stop the E. coli and the Ebola. And they were threatened to lose their seat as professors in the university. Now, for the first time, we see with the scientists like you in Ghana, in what they call Atomic Agency, that you're confirming what your colleague in South Carolina University did 2 years ago, and submitted at the presidential office to the World Health Authority. All the equipment were taken off of them, and they were told they cannot show such a thing. Now it's in public. But we understand the way how it works. The reason your scientists in the Atomic Energy Authority Research Lab see the reduction in all the what you call bacteria or viruses is because any bacteria, any virus has a base amino acid. So with your soap, you have already created the base amino acid by adding another energy to it with your GANS of CO2 or copper oxide or CHT or any GANS you add to it, the power of it becomes more than the bacteria or the virus which is in the stomach, Salmonella or whatever. And the transfer of the energy from one to one shows you the reduction total, because you transfer energy from the bacteria or the virus, which already have a common denominator of the amino acid of the protein. This is how it works. Understand the science behind it, not just coming up with figures, because when you understand it, you can explain it easily. Now you see why I asked you to come to this. This is what you need to do in a space. You have a common denominator. You're in the space lab of the Ghana Atomic Energy Authority. That's where we work with. This is our base home. So when Ghana produces the first spaceships into space, the knowledge you brought from Ghana's Atomic Energy Group gives you a step forward to understand how to protect man in a space. You need to have amino acid condition, power strength in MagRav, magnetic gravitational, which you can add slightly more to it, you guarantee life. You did not destroy the amino acid of the bacteria or the virus in your culture. All you've done is you depleted the energy of it. That's why it's left black. That's why you still see it and it doesn't air, because the amino, if you take the residual of the culture plates which you have, which the Dr. Nash and the others just explained to us, and analyze it, you will find out it's a pure amino acid. That you haven't destroyed, you depleted the energy. This is what we call space technology. Understanding the transfer of energy of the plasma. And in a very simple way, with a soap, you break a fantastic new knowledge in the world of space technology. This is what your scientists in the lab have to understand and start working on. This is what you need. Do you understand? Benjamin, are you with us? Or have we lost him? Hello? Are we here?
We are back. Yeah, we are back.
You're back. Okay.
Yeah.
Now you have to, as a man who understands the plasma and GANS and nanotechnology, transfer this knowledge to the scientists in the Space Institute, into Space Institute and the biology lab. Explain to them, they are sitting with you. We thank you for the knowledge you brought us, and we thank you for what you shared. In the purity of the knowledge, we just add to it. And now, it should be very easy, even if you add a small amount of, let's say 0.5% of soap, if the energy of that 0.5% is more than the bacteria which are within the sample test, they will share energy, you still will have amino acid at the end. Please test the residual which you left there, which you say they are black or they are there. Those will show in test to be a pure amino acid in nanostructure themselves. Is it possible to do that? Do you have the facilities to do that? Benjamin? They have connection issues.
Pardon? Mr. Keshe, we want to, we are back. We lost you for some couple of minutes. So we want to repeat yourself, your question and okay. Your demand.
What it is your job. Now you understand that you've been producing, human race has been producing the GANS of protein. And now you added the GANS of another material to increase the strength in the way you made the virus. To with it, you created a safe virus which we control is within our structure. That it could deplete the energy of the other viruses being E. coli, Ebola or Salmonella. It'll be interesting if you can take those black spots what you say there is no culture and see if there are still there amino acid without the energy of the virus or bacteria. And this confirms the correctness of the technology that you're depleting energy. So we can use soap, literally caustic or ash with human protein or any kind of protein and add a small amount of energy to it which is safe for us to overcome any virus or disease on this planet. You can digest it. You can use the GANS of the water, use the water of the GANS of the soap and the water of the GANS of what you made as a soap and take a spoonful of it for any kind of Salmonella which a man takes within seconds, within minutes, you see them finishing with Salmonella. So the soap, the way you made it, the way you added CO2, if you test it as a water of the GANS on a human body, you will find out Salmonella will walk away in no time, in few seconds. If you have a Salmonella poisoning, you have Ebola or your E. coli, or any kind of virus infection from any microbes or virus, just take the water of it. If it enters your digestion system, you can make these soaps as a water which you made as a patches and put it on the stomach, put it on the digestion system. You don't need to digest it. The energy transfer, you'll find out Salmonella disappears in no time. You understand? Are you there, Benjamin?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I understand.
You understand?
I fully understand. That is why I told him that it will need the virus, pathogens or microorganism in no time. But they were looking, he was a little bit skeptical at first, but after he said, it worked as you told me, and he was happy with the results.
No, but you have to understand the process, what is happening, not the results. So you can repeat the process with the GANS of the soap and the CO2 in the patches the way you make, and put it on, anybody come, suffers from E. coli or Ebola or Salmonella or any other infection, that you can put it on their body and the energy transfer will do the same thing without digesting it or using it. So it would be interesting if you put this culture material and don't mix with it any of the soap. Put it in the environment of the soap, seal it and see if the same thing happens to the bacteria. You understand? So you don't mix your culture with the soap. You put the culture with the bacteria and virus in it, in the soap which is already CO2 or copper oxide or whatever with the soap, and see if the bacteria changes and becomes ineffective. So we don't need to eat it, we don't need to drink it, we use this energy to see the conversion. Is that possible? Or
it's possible. Yeah. It's possible. It's possible.
Just rub the soap on the culture box and see if the bacteria start disappearing where you only left with amino acid. Make the soap and drop the culture box in it. Let it float in it without soap penetrating into the culture bait. And let us know.
Mr. Keshe, this is Ali speaking. You were talking about the diamonds, and I wanted to share something on my screen.
No, we are not going there. Stay out of the time being.
Okay, thank you.
So, what is important is to transfer the energy of the GANS, not the GANS itself. You understand?
Yes, sir.
So please come back to us if the result is correct or how much you have to increase the intensity. But don't forget, some culture plates, if it's glass or if it's plastic, will not or absorb some of the energy. This is very important. We see this when we create plasmatic fields. When you use field of plasma, depends if you use glass or plastic, different strength fields interacts. So you don't need to have the soap. You can even make the water of the soap and the water of the GANS on the top when you mix it, let the water settle. And if anybody has a Salmonella or E. coli, or you can do the testing, you should see instantaneously the reduction and transfer of the micro or virus into only protein, where the energy is transferred into the plasma of the rest of the GANS which you do. You don't kill the bacteria, you don't destroy the bacteria. This is one of the things we always had a huge problem with nuclear centers. When they do the Raman spectroscopy, they don't see the energy. They see the effect of the energy and they see the material. They say, this is the material, but we don't see anything different. Because GANS transfers energy, because it is a plasma. So do some tests for us and come back, because it takes you 5 minutes to do this test.
Yeah. It's not me, it's Daniel. If his outfit doesn't have a lot of work, then he can do it quickly for us. But sometimes they are loaded with a lot of jobs, so getting him do some of this thing for us quickly takes a lot of, you know.
Move him into the Keshe Foundation side of the research. Then you have him all the time.
Okay.
Now you're part of the structure of Ghana Atomic, and we are embedded as company in there getting done. moving into the Keshe Foundation as a side of the, what do you call it, the institute, and then it'll be yours. It's just speak with the directors if you can pinch. Then it's full time.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Do you have any questions?
The skin of Dr. Nash.
Is it? Dr. Nash is here. Nash, he wants to see your skin.
The skin, you were going to cross the skin.
Let's see which of the camera will come.
Is that the...
Yeah, he wants to see your hand. Mr. Keshe is coming, he will show you the skin.
You have to share the camera. We have lost you. We just got your voice. You got to share your camera. Yes.
Can you see me?
No.
Video
we
settings.
Have the voice, but we don't see the picture. Wait, is that with our side or is it with their side?
Somebody has to highlight the video and zoom here, Vince.
Yeah, okay. They're coming back and see the picture. Okay.
Okay, Nash, you show your hand, sir, to them.
Hello, Dr. Nash.
Okay. That is the hand of Nash, which was treated with the GANS. In fact, he's here, so he can tell you what happened to the hand.
Yeah, good morning, Mr. Keshe.
Hi, good morning, Dr. Nash.
Yeah, as you can see, with the picture, my hand is almost taking the natural skin.
You need to go further down the arm. We see your elbow and up.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell us how the accident happened.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, after I've sustained the bends, Ben came round. I showed it to him and he assured me that he can treat it in a matter of days. So every day he comes round to treat my hand. And just the second day I started seeing changes. And as we can see now, my skin the place has toned up with my natural skin. And even the hair there, which used not to grow as before, it's now growing faster as I can see. So actually the GANS have worked and it's so marvelous. And if I show my hand to someone that's where I had the accident, they tend not to even believe it. But it's actually worked.
What was the accident?
I was driving when I veered off the road, hit two other cars by the roadside, and my hand was on the steering wheel. So when the airbags popped up, because my hand was the first or the nearest object to the airbag, it scratched the lower part of my arm, getting to the main vein, that's the arteries there. But fortunately, and God being so merciful, it didn't touch my vein, so I didn't bleed. Only that I sustained severe bends at that portion of my hand.
And how long ago is that?
I had the accident 25th January this year.
Uh-huh.
And the treatment just took barely 5 days.
5 days.
5 days, yes.
So since January, there was no change. And now?
Yeah, after the sore has been healed, then the skin, I stopped. I stopped going to the clinic altogether. And I used the GANS treatment for just 5 days. And I removed the gauze. And it started taking the natural skin from then on.
That's beautiful. Thank you very much. Benjamin, you need to buy two headphones that you don't need to pinch the others.
I'll do that.
Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us. Let us know when you do the test and how we can go. Thank you, Dr. Nash. Okay. Thank you for all of what you said.
I don't know whether the folks here have a question or they want to ask anything. So there are a lot of them here. Students from various universities doing their practical attachments here. Their internship here. There are other staff or colleagues. My team, most of them are here. Esther is here. Esther, come around from the...
I can tell you, would you like to make the announcement or do you want me to make the announcement, Benjamin?
Which one? Any of the two. But I will prefer you doing that.
So, okay.
That is Esther here. And hello. Behind her directly is Lebanon. And then Sharif is also here. So Sharif, wave your hand for them to see. Lebanon, wave your hand. And then Esther is right with me here. And Nafisa is right over there. Nafisa is here. Nafisa, wave your hand for them to see. They were all part of the soap making process. So that's my team here. My team. In the, and then Nash himself is around. So that's Nash here. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much. As I said, the African nations with leaders face technology. And we see it now. You bring in knowledge so freely on condition of patents and scientific papers. You show the raw state of matter. And I assure you one thing, hundreds of thousands of the scientists around the world watch this program. You are watched by the world leaders today while you are presenting. And they are understanding how easy we share knowledge in this foundation. And I thank you for doing it. But we have a surprise for you. In August of this month, Keshe Foundation will hold a summit in Ghana for the African nations. So all the African Keshe Foundations in having problem in getting visa to come to Europe, we organize the first Keshe Foundation Summit in Ghana with the help of the Ghanaian Keshe Foundation, and it's on the shoulder of the Benjamin, Alex, and Dr. Gota to see this through. This is the first time we are organizing in Africa, and we organize it in the center of Africa.
So Mr. Keshe, the people want to know, although I know what we are going to discuss about this in the summit, the people want to know what the summit is all about on
which dimension. We will release it. It's the scientific, it's for Ghana to enter into space technology, plus the way you are doing it, and we'll try to be there. I'll try to be in Ghana for the summit, and at the same time, by then, we should be able to see different application of the space technology on the health. And as we came to Ghana through Dr. Nana, where as part of the spaceship program of the Ghanaian government, now we bring the knowledge that Ghana can join China and the others on the edge of the space, as you've done. The beauty of it is you don't realize what you just dispersed as a knowledge in Passau. You open one of the biggest mysteries of man for 6,000 years, how it works. So simply, it's not what you bring as pieces of papers or culturing. It's the knowledge which you share so unconditionally. Now really we can see this paper you just shown, this simple presentation by such a beautiful scientist like you lot, broken all the rules of the present economical cycle. What you just showed, how easily these bacteria can be defeated or can be balanced, has been the dream of the world of medicine. Thousands of people die because of these bacteria every day around the world, Salmonella and the others. And with a simple presentation, you brought everything to a stop. the knowledge you shared in past hour has been the dream of humanity for thousands of years to solve. And so, humbly you've done. Today, microbiologists, the leading pharmaceutical organizations around the world are kicking themselves. The term of selling things are finished. Ghana comes on presentation. You've been watched by the world leaders. I assure you today, the program you presented has been watched by President Obama. Chinese leadership is online most of the time. Are you still there?
Yes, sir.
You've been watched by NASA. You've been watched by the health authority organizations. You've been watched by the most leading scientific organizations around the world. We speak to them and we know that they're online. We monitor them. So, in a very simple way, you've shown there is no need for peer review to control. You have destroyed half of the soap industry in the world. You destroyed half of the pharmaceutical business in the world, where the man can make a caustic with some animal fat from the steak left last night on the table, have the caustic of the fat, add a little bit of oxide from the copper of the wire in the house, you can cure Salmonella. You can cure Ebola and E. coli. When your colleagues in such university, we taught them how to make the same thing as you just shown us 2 years ago, and they took it to the presidential palace of the president of the Sri Lanka to show to the health authority, World Health Authority, which were there, how easily Ebola and E. coli can be destroyed, they confiscated and they threatened them to lose their position. Now you show them they cannot silence 20 beautiful scientists like you in Ghana. Now the whole world knows how correct the technology is because you presented it. What you presented in about past half an hour, you've been working past 6 weeks, has taken scientists of the world hundreds of years to solve. And there it is. If the pharmaceuticals understand it, you do the test with the energy, just use it as a liquid soap, as a liquid water of the soap, and use it, you will find out no child in Africa should die of any more bacteria and diseases. And Africa will head walking the man out of diseases. This is what is the beautiful thing about it. So, but the most important part is understand the principle behind it. How it is you produce the GANS of the bacteria, amino acid, which is the structure of the man, you produce added stronger, a little bit stronger strength to it by CH2 or CO2, and now that little bit of a strength in the plasmatic condition is enough to deplete another amino acid which has a little bit of strength, we call it Salmonella, or the others which have been killing you. So you can literally walk your children of Africa out of all disasters. No child. Don't forget, if you have Alex on the line with you, doctors in Nigeria are doing the same thing as you do with GANS water, and people are walking away with malaria. Try, use the water of the soap you made and give it to the people who have malaria attack and watch how within 24 hours they change their position. Try it. Test it on the malaria and see how it works. Spray the rooms with the water of the soap of these GANSes and see if you can overcome malaria in no time. I lost my heart to Africa 25 years ago. I worked in Africa a long time and I've seen how my workers suffered from malaria, and now you have the solution. I worked in Gambia, and I've seen my people, how they suffered. They can't afford to pay for an injection of malaria. Now you can give them a water, cost nothing, they can walk away and with no suffering. I've seen the same thing in Kinshasa for years. So it's time for Ghana Space Institute and Ghana Atomic to deliver the first material against malaria and all the things which has been suffering world causing problem in Africa. I thank you for what you delivered.
Mr. Keshe, I'm not cutting you in. I wanted to try it with the veterinary people here. There is a veterinary unit of the Ghana Atomic Energy Commission, and I'm trying to work with the animals also. So it's something that I'm doing, but I didn't want to break the ice until you brought it in. So this the next thing I'll be doing with the veterinary people here. With they have a lot of animals, so and animals respond to treatment even faster than human beings because they have no attachments or whatsoever. So I'm going to do that with the veterinary unit also for the animal health also, and I will give you a feedback of what I find also there.
That's perfect. Let me add to what you're saying. You can use the same material in agriculture for pest control without chemicals. You can do, you don't destroy the life of the whatever. You change the environment that they cannot exist in. You have to understand how it works. When you use these water of these soaps in the field, in the agriculture side, they just change the feed the strength, the same as you did with the bacteria of Salmonella and the rest. So in that environment, the pests cannot exist. So you don't need to use chemicals, you use the same water. You can extend the knowledge. We've done this, it's been done in Brazil, it's done in China, and very soon the Chinese scientists will bring this knowledge in. So now you understand how it works, it's just transfer of energy. You create a new environment, so you can use it for anything. Today we announce the establishment of agriculture at keshefoundation.org, headed by Dr. Guta.
Guta
is set up, yes, in Kenya. He's been asked, this website is set, and from next Wednesday or the Wednesday after, we teach on Wednesday mornings to the agriculture scientists. If you're involved in agriculture, in Africa or anywhere around the world, the way we are teaching doctors on Wednesday afternoon, on Wednesday mornings we start teaching the agriculturists, because we ask you to come in, bring your technology that we can share. The teachings will be headed by Dr. Guta, and we, as I said, we're bringing leading scientists around the world to head different sections of the Keshe Foundation. And now will be done from Kenya. Dr. Guta is coming to Ghana very soon to be with you, to share knowledge. He is a well-respected researcher and developer of the agriculture side. Understand the technology you just developed and shared with us so freely and beautifully with him in regarding the agriculture. Then you understand, you don't need to bring any fertilizer, you don't bring any pesticides from anywhere around the world. Ghana will export water out of Ghana to its own culture. Understand the principle, understand the technology, understand the physiology of the interaction of creating new environment. Now you can become astronauts in no time. You develop it, you play with the same energy in creating lift and motion. When I met Dr. Ghana in Italy last, earlier on this year?
Last year,
yes, in conference, peace conference, I explained to her, we bring Ghana and Africa to be the crown jewel of space technology. And today is the example of it. So unconditionally, so humbly you sit there and you change the course of humanity in a very simple presentation. If you had somebody from Harvard or Oxford, they would have been sitting there with the tie expecting respect, I know too much. Africa is humble and we respect you for it. I hope we share more with you next week. Test it without the material. And on the other hand, on the Keshe Foundation, Universal Council on the Facebook, Caroline has already established a veterinarian section for those scientists who want to participate and add to the knowledge using the plasma technology to share with the others. When you go to Universal Council, when the trade union section, you can see how you can help your animals using what you just shared. Thank you very much, Benjamin. Thank you very much.
Mr. Nash wants to ask you a question, so.
Please.
Mr. Keshe, from today's presentation on the soap, if someone is diagnosed with a typhoid fever, can that person be treated?
Yes.
Use immediately. Water soap.
Yes. Yes, immediately. This test, influenza, and this kind of thing has been tested by TEPCO Japanese Nuclear Center for helping the people in Fukushima, in the winter cold. So all you need to do, and actually our Japan Keshe Foundation, Mr. Kan-san, showed the research which was done by TEPCO, where they put influenza on the food of the mouse, and afterwards there were no toxicity in the liver and there were no influenza. You can use it, use the water of it. Use the water of the soap, not the GANS itself. GANS is too powerful. If you see, if you go to 0.5 mil, you still get the same result. You can see you bombarded those poor bacteria in those plates by Hiroshima bomb. That's why they're not there. So what you got to understand, dilute it with the water in the ratio of 10 to 1. Every, let's say, 100 ml of the soap with the CO2, or try to use CO2 GANS water first and see you get a result. You can use the copper oxide GANS water with the soap. It'll be very powerful. It's a big punch. You understand? So use it three times, like two tablespoons, and two, three times a day. Slowly let the body take it. Don't use a copper oxide water GANS. It's too powerful. It's a bigger punch. Yeah? And you can walk them away with it. They'll walk away with that, because the research from Japan confirms your idea is correct, because we have data, we know it works. And it's done by TEPCO, the biggest research centers in energy production in Japan. Maybe we can announce something which will come to you in talking about the water. A lot of you know the organization called Umoto in Japan, with the water testing, they are well known. Mr. Umoto, and where he showed the love on it and everything else. Keshe Foundation is in negotiation development of the processes with Umoto Group. Mr. Hara Umoto, this is thanks to the work of Sylvester. We have delivered and we started, the final tests are done this week. We hopefully announce the cooperation of the Keshe Foundation with the Umoto Group with development of these kind of waters across the world. So we are going into participation with the major players in the world of science. And we, thanks to Sylvester, we delivered material. I received a text this morning, they're in the lab, just understanding the potency of it. And in the coming weeks, a joint venture company between Keshe Foundation and Umoto Group will be established in Japan for delivery of these kind of materials for different diseases and radiation. You can use these waters for all kind of influenzas, all kind of digestion of the heavy metals. If you have people with the digestion of metals, you can give them the water of the soap, and then you will see they reject the metal from the body. Mercury can be rejected, but with mercury, do not use CH3. With mercury, use only CO2, no copper oxide. Yeah. So the people who have like MS, a lot of MSs, or a lot of mental diseases caused through mercury fillings, now you give them CO2, you find a lot of neural repairs. But do not use copper oxide, because copper links up with mercury and with potassium in the body of the man. It can create a different condition. It's not hazardous, but it's something you don't need. So you can clean metal toxicity from the body using the water of the GANS. And if it's not enough, you just add a little bit more. Try to use, once you make the culture the base, use the culture base. Don't use to use it. Use the water, because it transferred the homogeneous energy to the water. And now you made the soap mixture with different GANSes. Just use it as base. You can use it for hundreds of years. Just put water on it and you collect the harvested water and use it. It has the same effect.
Yeah, Mr. Keshe, you mentioned a teaspoon or two. Does that mean that the patient have to drink it?
Just drink the water. Yeah. Yes, okay. Yes. Just the water, okay. Because now you have made the GANS. Mix it, let it settle to the bottom and use the water. And it works effectively. I tell you how effectively it works.
Thank you.
I tell you. You shared so much beautiful knowledge. You just let me share with you a little bit of knowledge for those who are with us.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, we are running a trial on using the GANS and the GANS water for what we call supplements for eye and for skin. You are using coconut and cocoa cream. We are using olive oil as this for the same purpose. For the eye drops, I'm using a CO2 water, not the GANS of CO2. I explained this, you're not the first one to hear, but I explained this yesterday with a teaching with the doctors. It's well known around the people who know me, I suffer from degeneration of eye, which means I'm losing my sight slowly in different dimensions. And I even switched from a normal telephone to retina screens just to be able to read at least easier. Now that we have launched the GANS water for eye as an eye drop, I started using the eye drop water GANS in my eyes last Sunday. I explained this in the medical teaching yesterday. And I could not see, even reading the phone, I mean from the mobile phone, I had to concentrate, narrow my eyes that I could see the pictures. I changed the bigger screen in past couple of weeks to be able to see more. And first time I used the eye drop in my eyes, I had a strange headache, a strange tinkling feeling in the back of my brain. When I used it the second time, I had the tinkling on my tongue. It was very strange for about hours. But since literally the first day since Monday, I can see what I could not see before. This morning just become I come on the presentation. I was with Caroline in my office, and the table is there. The paper is about 2 meters away from me on the table and her. I said, Caroline, look, I can read the number. It's 16042016. She said, you can read from this distance now. I said, I don't know. Yes. I can see the new world. I feel the pressure in my eye has changed. You know, your eyes narrows down and your facial pressure changes. Now I feel relaxation in my face because I don't need to concentrate. Now I could not see at night. Yesterday I see totally new different world. So I'm testing the GANS water directly into my own eyes because I suffer badly. It's suffering when I go to sleep at night. I had a lot of pressure in my eyes all the time. This morning I woke up with no pressure. It was a pleasure to be young again. I can see I was sitting here, if you come in the auditorium, I was sitting on the second row. Many times in past year being here, I sit on these chairs while you lot teach, and I try to look, I can't read. I know the book is there, is my books on the table. Now, from here, I can read it, the word, what they are. I'm about 5 meters, 10 meters away. I can read the books. And that's in 4 days of just spraying some gas water of the CO2 into my eye. Because if I deliver a technology, I have to be standing the test of the technology myself. So I see the difference. So you can try it. Try it safely. There are thousands of people with eye degeneration. It has worked on me. But as I said yesterday to the doctors, I'm not interested in me seeing better. What I'm interested in is why in changing the condition of my eye, the tongue nerves reacted. This is a strange point. What has the eyes got to do with the nerves of the tongue? Why my pain in the back of my head where there is a section in regarding the writing had a problem? I'm left-handed. I stopped writing because I can't see properly. Now it means when you adjust the eye, everything else in the body of the man, in the brain which adjusted itself for your disability which is coming up, now is recorrecting itself too. You understand? Look at the implementation and what this technology brings, not just because you did the soap and it cleaned. It's not a orange juice or a skin of orange oil which makes it thinner. The technology is a transfer of the energy. Use these soaps and see how you can take the stains off. How do they affect the stain? Not only the bacteria. Do we transfer the energy? Do we need any water to wash anymore? Or can we put the soap near it and transfer the energy from it? You understand? This is what we have to extend the knowledge. We are opening a new door, and thanks very much to offices of, I always said, I was telling yesterday or last Friday to the people in the Italian nuclear center, I was the guest of them. Thanks to the offices of CIA who brought us to Ghana, we thank the American authorities for bringing us to Ghana to be able to do free research and development. It has brought beautiful people like you with your knowledge with us. We work with everyone. We have no boundaries and borders in sharing knowledge. And thanks to people who are around the foundation, knowing what we can do, now we can see the beauty of Africa and the knowledge of their scientists. It'll be nice to invite or to allow the other scientists to come to Ghana Space Institute, and as Benjamin said a few minutes ago, you have scientists from all over the world. We are there at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute Summit in August. I have left the time and the place in the hand of Benjamin. We will be glad to have, we have scientists all over Africa who work in different aspects of the Keshe Foundation to be there. It's time, and I said this many times, and as you know, as I said, I spent years in Africa. It's time that the scientists of Africa do not have to clean laboratories in America to pay to become doctors, to be kept for their knowledge back in America. I have many friends, doctors, professors, who did everything in US and Europe to become doctors and scientists, and then they kept out of their nation to the assets of where they cleaned the toilets with. Now it's time for the Europeans to come to Africa and learn knowledge from the birthplace. You have beautiful scientists. I have a lot of respect for doctors and professors and scientists in Africa because you spent time deliberately and a lot of resources of the families which they don't have to become scientists where you sit here. And it's very different than somebody who's given a grant and everything on the table, you just go and read the book, we give you a degree. A lot of scientists like you, a lot of scientists we see in Iran nuclear industry, in atomic structures of the East Asia, you work to become where you are. It wasn't given to you on a silver spoon. And for that, you learn the true science, and there is a lot of respect for you. I work with a lot of you. I have very good friends in different African nations over 30 years, 40 years. And this is time to change the position. Let the world come to Africa to learn from Africa how easily you can share knowledge unconditionally. Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us today. Let us see what you bring us next week. What are you trying to show us?
Mr. Keshe, they are fighting over it. Who should I give? A car unit here, so...
Car unit? You stop your manufacturing company, and then you can share it with anybody you like. As you know, Ghana manufacturing, he's giving a lot of car units and home units and giving it to everybody. Half of the management of the Ghana New Atomic Center are living on free electricity. So we have to make it free for the whole of the nation. We're setting up the factory up very soon in Ghana to produce all these units. Benjamin works during the day in the center, and at night he makes units for everybody else. Thank you very much, Benjamin. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For the Atomic Energy. Thanks for sharing knowledge with us.
Thank you. We thank you, and because of our busy schedules, we want to still, you know, go and then do our work. A lot of them have left their offices for this program, so I would like to thank you for, you know, watching us and listening to us. We will do what Mr. Keshe has asked us to do, and then come and then present it again. Thank you all.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you indeed for sharing knowledge. Thank you, Ghana. Is there, now you know that we have the agricultural at Keshe Foundation as kfssi.org. We start the teaching on Wednesday mornings, and we'll come headed by Dr. Kota from Kenya, so all the programs will come from Africa. If you have knowledge to share with Africa doctors at KFSSI to share knowledge with us how we can use this new technology as we do with other scientists and doctors around the world. It's important to share knowledge the way we do because we have made it unconditional. And it is important to share knowledge we do because if this program gives a knowledge to one man to save the life of one child by simple what it was shown just in past few, let's say, hours by Ghanaian scientists, we have served the purpose of living. If we have managed to stop one person to suffer from salmonella or the other bacterial or viruses with a simple spoon of water which is produced the way you do, and you showed us so freely, it was worth establishing and going through all the process of setting up the Ghana and Keshe Foundation. I thank you for it. The knowledge is shared unconditionally. I would like to see if we challenge the scientists from MIT, we challenge the scientists from Cornell University, if the Cornell University scientists would like to come and share so openly their papers without being peer reviewed. Let the humanity peer review the paper than a few what I call crooks of the peer review structure. I think we'll make the soap, a lot of us around the world, and we'll give you our peer review in the next couple of weeks, thanking you for saving a lot of pain for us. Your paper has been peer reviewed, your presentation, and you passed with the first class. It's published, what you've shown by millions of people see it, where a peer review published will be read by a few handful of people who might benefit by it financially. Thank you very much, Ghana. Where do we have to go now, Rick? What's our next step?